Camp Winnie.
Welcome back, guys. We're at Shark Bay. It's not called Shark Bay because of what you're thinking. I think it's just called Shark Bay because that's what Keppel, what's his name? Augustus Keppel thought the bay was full of sharks. Isn't that what you said this afternoon?
Yeah.
So now and again when you're traveling, and this is why we travel and you meet great people, you do come across the odd hidden gem in the traveling community. That's happened today. I'm here with a lovely lady all the way from New Zealand, Tanya, g'day.
And kia ora.
The reason I say hidden gem, Tanya's on her own, and let me guess, you've been travelling Australia on your own for 4 years.
Yes.
What an achievement. And you've done it all in a, what am I saying,
a 17-year-old
Land Rover.
More than, what's 96? How many years is that?
14, 15, 17
four,
years.
No,
hang on.
27.
That's 27 years.
27 years.
Yeah. 27-year-old, and you do all the repairs on that old girl yourself?
Not all of them. I do oil changes on the road. I keep diff oil with me, and I change, do that sort of stuff. But anything more than that, like a clutch, I couldn't do a clutch like you did. But I do the air filters and the oil filters, and I change the oil.
Hey, it sounds like you probably could do a clutch in the old girl. But I think this is a fantastic setup, and this isn't having a mock on people with V8 Sahara Land Cruisers, because I think they're an exceptional vehicle, and I think people do extraordinary things with the V8 Sahara Land Cruiser. But why you are so unique, you said something to me this afternoon. You've painted this thing with rattle cans, and you don't care a hell if it gets scratched, because you are using it. Not abusing it, you are using it.
Yep.
And that's why it's so great, and that's why you have travelled Australia for 4 years, on and off. I remember you said you worked at the cattle stations and whatnot.
Yeah.
So out of all the people we've met, and this is our second lap around this whole country, I love the adventurous type of men and women like yourself that are taking it on horns first. You like that? You're a country girl off a farm, horns first.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what you've done.
Yeah. Well, I mean, Australia's just perfect for it. I mean, in New Zealand, a big adventure would be like half a day. Whereas here, I can drive down a 4x4 track and I might pop out a week later. And I might not have seen anybody, and I'll have seen the most amazing creatures and landscape. It's just, it's absolutely perfect for it. And you need to have a vehicle. Well, some people can take a Winnebago anywhere.
Well, this is where we met.
homage.
Well, we met this afternoon on a pretty grady four-wheel drive track.
Gnarly. I'm just saying, it was gnarly. I'm like, what are they doing? Where are they going?
I was thinking that, not just you. Well, that's where we met, guys. We're on the peak of a big gnarly four-wheel drive track. And,
in the Winnebago.
Yet again, we're places where we probably shouldn't be. But then again, you meet wonderful people like you that have the same passionate heart. And isn't it funny? I want to tell you something. We actually have motorhomed all around New Zealand for our honeymoon.
Ah.
Here you are from New Zealand, traversing this wonderful country.
Yep.
And isn't it great?
Yeah, it's awesome.
This is a motorhoming haven here.
Yeah, and all Australia, I mean, you guys caught camping, but and what amazes me about Aussies too, like not any, okay, you guys have set a new record, but where people take their caravans, I'll go in some remote place and I think I'm really tough, and then I rock up and there's people with caravans, I'm like, how do they get that here? But this is a whole nother level of something else. I just can't believe this, so yeah.
Well actually, like, so we'll do a channel crossover. Because Tanya's got her own YouTube channel. What's your YouTube?
Findeverybeach.com.
Findeverybeach.com.
And here we go, another beach.
We like the sound of that.
And Lisa said after we met you, I'm going with her. Findeverybeach.com.
Sometimes you have to go through mountains and rivers and waterfalls. For a while I was like findeverywaterfall.com as I was coming through across the savannah and down through all the places. But yeah, back to beaches and it feels good.
Good on you.
Yeah, yeah. Look at the spot we've got tonight.
All right, I want to ask you something. What is your all-time highlight of travelling Australia? That's a tough question, that's why I like asking it.
I'm a bit of a loner. I don't normally do people things. I'm more about landscape, but it's actually the people I meet. And a memory for me is actually it will be associated with the people I met at the place. So sure. You guys will now be a part of my Australia memory.
But
landscape, Kings Canyon. Yeah. But then it's remote places, like some of the places along the West Coast. The scenery, the colour, like the red and then the turquoise blue, and then no one's around. So, I mean, yeah, there are no favourites.
So you have found solitude doing this trip, your 4 years of your life.
Yep.
That's a long part of your life, by the way, to be in another country. Oh, we're cousins, are we? Kiwis and Aussies. Let's get that straight out of there. We're close cousins.
We still have our differences. I still can't say Grant or
healthy,
dance right.
Healthy differences. Healthy differences. Yeah. I love it.
But I mean, there's no... And you asked me before, do I get lonely? And I just don't.
Yeah.
And I'm a bit of a go-go. I talk too fast. I go too fast. But out here, I mean, I'll just sit like you guys and just watch the sunset. And my favourite's dawn. I just love being up for the dawn and watching the sunrise.
See, you strike me as a lady that's really in touch with nature. You've really grasped this, haven't you?
Well, you can't help it when you're out here. You're not connected to TV or this world. You just wait. You do hear the birds and you do kind of, you become more in tune with the daylight hours, don't you? Have you found that?
Yes.
You've said it better than I could have.
Yeah.
Yeah, you have the camera.
I mean, at the moment... I'm lucky if I'm awake at 8 o'clock at night, like it's dark, you know, like I'm up with the dawn, which is really early at the moment. It's like quarter to five o'clock. Yeah. And it's a great time of day to drive when it's too hot and you get to go places before people have even got up and had their coffees. And then I'm already there. And then, by the time it's 7 o'clock, 7:30, if I've, you know, done some video downloading, I'm exhausted.
Yeah.
You know,
we've got to say goodnight to her and goodbye to her.
Oh, no. It's almost my bedtime, you guys. Just
better wrap this up early. Good on you, Tanya. It sounds like you've really, doing this whole thing, and it's easy for me to say, I'm an Australian living in Australia, but you've come to another country, you've really taken the leap of faith. It sounds like you're so glad you did it.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
It's moulded your life.
Yeah, and I've been wanting to do it for years, and I finally did it when I waited for my father to die, and it sounds terrible. And then when he was finally gone, I'm like, okay, I'm going to do it. I'm not going to wait till I retire and don't retire. I'm doing it now. Yeah. I'm just pretending I'm in my 20s and doing my big OE again. I'm just kind of 30 years on. So I just don't want to miss the opportunity.
Good on you.
It's on the bucket list. I had to do it. Couldn't not do it.
Well, you know what? That does sound like we've only caught a snippet of Tanya. But it's actually my pleasure and the pleasure of my family to meet you. We're going to put on some music, guys, and have a couple of beers and just watch this. I think it's going to be an incredible sunset tonight. And take the night away.
Thanks, Shannon.
All right, mate. Uru.
So we've stopped for a lunch break and dump point to offload the toilet cassette. And oh my goodness, the amount of flies is ridiculous. We couldn't even come outside without having our fly nets on. So we have an interesting appearance today, do we not?
I've never seen anything like it. It is crazy. Look at them.
Nuts.
This is crazy.
Needless to say, the kids are staying in the van.
It's been through the media that they're having a very big fly swarm here in Western Australia at the moment. It's very well publicised. We hadn't really seen them until today.
Until now.
I've never seen anything like it in my life, I swear.
It's ridiculous. Anyway, I wish I had a full body net. It's crazy. And even though it's fly net, feel like you can't breathe with it on. Anyway, better than having flies all in my eyes.
Oh, they're a lifesaver. That is ridiculous. Oh, it's hot, yeah.
This is not easy, trying to map out some important dates of the calendar and where we might be. Fun, whilst it is, trying to figure out places to be, who we're gonna see.
Places to be, who we're gonna see. You're a poet and you never know it.
There you go.
You haven't seen us do mapping for a while, but we do this, more than we show on our videos, but hey, we have, yes, old school, I know. Remember these? Anyone that's about
40 or 50?
Late 40s or above, remember these? The Motorways of Australia. There you go. It's like a little leather pouch with all the maps. You've got to have these, because sometimes technology fails. And trust me on that, it really does. We do Wikicamps and Google Maps, etc. But Wikicamps had a bummer this year and lost everyone's information.
Mm-hmm. So, not good.
Yep. Cashless society, guys, it's gonna work, right? Sometimes the digital age can fail you, so you gotta have a big brief of maps. We've got West Australia, Queensland, every state, Northern Territory, Victoria, Tasmania, Cape York, let's not forget him. That's the thickest map of the lot. What's it trying to tell us? There's a lot to do. And we're currently studying South Australia, New South Wales. Basically, how to re-enter the Earth's atmosphere. How to re-enter orbit back to our Sydney lives. We've made many and varied phone calls today to people back at home, other travellers, people we've met who live interstate, about road access, how long it takes between towns, what's there to see. We're being very, very careful not to double up on stuff we saw on our first lap in 2021. Yeah. Sometimes you have to. The Nullarbor, for example, but hey, stay tuned. There's a few things on Nullarbor that we didn't even know about during our first trip. Some very, very cool stuff. We have been here all day. All day.
All day, yes.
Mapping. I'm not calling ourselves Captain Cook or explorers of any stretch of the imagination, but you've got to have some sort of plan. And a plan we have. I just want to slide into third base, or home base as it is, on my hip.
Anyway, I need another piece of paper because I need to start again.
Pardon the baseball analogy. I want to slide into home base, seeing everything I possibly can see before our entry back into Sydney. Anyway, we'll keep going. Stay tuned. That's all I can tell you. I've got a fair idea where we'll be Christmas, We've got a fair idea where we'll be on New Year's Eve. Very cool, by the way. And I know what we're doing in New South Wales. We're going to go out with a bang, guys. Okay. Back to the paperwork in the office. Here we are at the beautiful Durian Bay. Some fun facts. Did you know that Australian sea lions only live in Western Australia and South Australia? I didn't know that either. Just in case you wanted to know.
There's Mum.
Gestures.
Hi, Mum.
Hey Chloe, I've got the drone in the air. Look out! Back in 2020 is when we started our YouTube channel, Camp Winnie, and we had no idea that the subscription base would reach far and beyond Australia. We've gone around some countries around the world and we've made friends, social media friends of course, with a couple, Keith and Joy. They are fellow motorhomers and they're from all the way over in the United States of America. Not far from New York, Maryland,
yes,
is that right?
Maryland.
And they've followed our travels since the very start in early 2021. They're beautiful people. They've supported us on our entire journey. They've shown great interest. They've been very generous with their time, very kind with their comments on our social media channels, and even offered up their motorhome for us to come over to the United States and tour America. Can you imagine? Camp Winnie does the States.
One day.
So they've reached out to us again and they've asked us for a mailing address, not an email address, a physical mailing address, because they wanted to send us something. We don't know what it is. We're in Perth over the other side of Australia from our hometown. We've arrived here at the post office. We're going to go and pick it up. They won't tell us what it is. They've even asked us to not look at the description of the contents of this package, this parcel, just to go and get it and open it without reading it. So,
early Christmas present for Camp Winnie.
Keith and Joy, we owe you at least that to abide by your wishes. We're going to go and pick it up now and rip it open, see what the mystery package is all about. And you guys, you've got no idea what it means to us, your unwavering support and your interest in us as a family. You are absolutely obsessed with Australia. You've been here many times yourself in a motorhome.
And on the countdown for next year's trip again.
Like, these Americans, guys, they've been everywhere. They always comment, don't they?
They do. They've been all the places we've been to and we're showcasing to everybody, they've already been.
Yeah.
And they've always had nice comments to say or asking us about our time there. So, yeah, it's really interesting to find people from another country has done more travel than we have in our own country.
I know.
Yeah.
Like this American couple, they have peppered their house with memorabilia of Australian stuff. So you guys have a great interest, a great healthy interest in Australia, and I love that. So all right, let's go and have a look.
Let's go.
And see what you sent us.
Let's go.
Feeling it's a flag. Something tells me.
No.
Really?
What's
on
it?
Is it our logo?
Oh, I got a tail logo.
You are very creative, Keith and
wow.
Joy.
Oh my god.
Wow.
This is cool.
That's a big one.
I haven't seen our logo blown up that huge before.
Wow.
It's double-sided.
And it's the new logo.
It's double-sided.
Oh my god.
Oh, that's hilarious. That's really, really nice.
Wowee. Thank you.
Fair dinkum.
That's awesome.
That's
crazy.
Turn
it around.
Fly it high and proud.
Fly it loud and proud.
Thanks, guys. Thanks very much.
That's very, very thoughtful.
That's our drawing, Mum.
It is.
Do you know what?
Have a go.
That is...
Very good.
I'm speechless. I didn't see it coming. I didn't know it was going to be our flag. That is straight from your heart, guys, and thank you so much, straight from our heart. We're going to fly it. We're going to fly it high and mighty, let me tell you.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's really cool.
Awesome.
Hey, you got to advertise, right?
Hi, it's Keith And Joy.
From Fairhill, Maryland. We enjoy getting up every Sunday morning, having a stretch and a coffee, and watching updates of what Camp Winnie's up to. Anyway, we hope to see everybody there in 2024. It's going to be soon. Thanks.
Bye. Bye.